Yeah, for sure. Listen, I gotta go. There's a new client here. All right, later, Satan. Hey, kid. So you wanna be the next big thing in metal? Well, I hate to tell you, but the gent is dead. Yeah, and tech metal, and black metal, and basically anything that reaches the review pages of those metal-ruining scumbags at metalsucks.net is dead. Fun fact for you, did you know that 95% of the ocean remains undiscovered? That's right, just like you and just like your new oceanic-themed metal band. Guys like Atlantis Chronicles have already paved the way, but it's up to you to take it to the next level. It's time to abandon the ways of the past. No more well-bearded YouTube guitarists with headless 9-string guitars plugged into their laptops. No, you're gonna take inspiration from Poseidon, the ocean king himself, and summon your own army of brutal ocean creatures to be your bandmates. Here's the lineup. This here is Mark the Blobfish. He'll be running your merch table. He was voted ugliest creature on Earth by the Ugly Animal Preservation Society. He's slightly less dense than water, allowing him to easily float around, and he has practically no muscle mass, so he spends little to no energy on anything. Perfect for a merch guy. Gus, Northern Stargazer and your new roadie, has the meanest mug in the business. Most of his body mass is in his face. He also has electric organs in his head that can generate and transmit an electric shock, which will be useful as a backup generator for those dive bar gigs. Despite his pissy looks, you don't have to worry much about Gus. He'll spend most of his days passed out on the floor waiting for his next meal to float by. On rhythm guitar, I've called up a truly hideous goblin shark named Tony. He's known as a living fossil in the industry. His family lineage dates back 125 million years. Tony has been the other guitarist for every touring band this side of the Cenozoic era. Just try not to stare at his face too often. He's very sensitive for an old guy. Bringing up the bottom end is this humpback anglerfish, Mel. She lives up to 4,500 meters below sea level, so she doesn't see much daylight. The glowing light on her head attracts a lot of attention from her prey, and males are constantly trying to attach themselves to her in order to mate, and how could they not? Just look at that gorgeous smile. This sarcastic fringe head named Neo is gonna be the perfect lead vocalist for you, although he's a bit of a diva. He's pretty aggressive and very territorial. You could say he's got a bit of a Napoleon complex. But despite his huge mouth, he's relatively harmless. He only ever gets in fights with other fringe heads by putting his mouth on their mouth to see whose is bigger. He says he's totally not gay, but we know he's gonna come out someday. This gal is something from another planet. Your new lead guitarist goes by Black and is from the family of barbel dragonfish. She has a long and sleek black body and a head like a xenomorph. Black produces bioluminescent infrared light that she uses to hunt prey. Her long fangs are unique to the females of her kind, unlike the male dragonfish, who are toothless, 90% smaller, and completely gutless. She says the sole purpose of males is to aid her in reproduction. She's gonna be great, just keep her away from the press. Lucky for you, I've got the best rhythm section in the deep blue sea to agree to play with you. At up to 43 feet long, his kind was long considered to be a legend from pirate fairy tales until his recent discovery. Meet Archie, the giant squid. Archie is believed to be the only species of giant squid in the ocean. He has a surprisingly complex brain and nervous system for a sea creature, which, paired with his 8 arms and 2 giant tentacles, will be perfect for the complex rhythms of the world's greatest oceanic metal band. Now the band is assembled. You'll be opening up for Death Clock this summer in the heaviest, deepest, most brutal part of the ocean, the Mariana Trench! I'll leave it up to you to think of a band name and leave it in the comments below. I'm Whitney Moore, thanks for watching.